Nearly one in 10 recovered COVID-19 patients here in Singapore suffer from long COVID syndrome. They have persistent side effects months after recovering from the initial infection. Now, that's according to a study by the National Center for Infectious Diseases. Sherlyn Xia tells us more.
For this COVID-19 survivor, it took almost 8 months for her to feel normal again after being discharged from hospital.
A lot of the breathlessness and then these body aches on the right side of my shoulder that lasted for quite a while. Headaches, very common. I had taken so much paracetamol last year in 8 months that I have not taken combined in about 20 years.
She belongs in a rare group of recovered patients who suffer from long-term effects of COVID-19, also known as long COVID syndrome. Beyond breathlessness and aches, patients also suffer from respiratory illnesses like cough. These symptoms can persist for up to 6 months after recovering from the initial infection. According to the National Center for Infectious Diseases, around 1 in 10 recovered patients report such persistent symptoms. That's from a study of over 280 patients who've been tracked since last January. Long COVID's mostly seen among cases with severe infection.
They have eventually recovered and got back to their usual activities. It is possible that this chronic inflammation may have some long-term consequences, so an increased risk of, say, cardiovascular events, so strokes or heart inflammation, or an increased risk, say, of developing diabetes later.
But Dr. Yang notes that long COVID syndrome is rare, and Singapore's overall rate of the condition would be lower than the study's findings. That's because patients involved in the study had more severe infection than the milder cases more commonly seen across the population. And as nationwide vaccination gets underway, there will be fewer cases of long COVID syndrome.
Getting vaccination does protect against infection. And if you don't get COVID, you won't get long COVID. Secondly, we know that even with people who do get infection despite vaccination, the severity of the infection is less. And so I think they will then have a lower chance of developing these long-term symptoms or long-term complications from COVID subsequently.
NCID has started a second study focusing on some 100 recovered patients and hopes to have results by the end of the year.